Steve Dotto here. How the heck you doing this fine day? Me? I'm somewhat overwhelmed by the response that we got to our video that we posted just yesterday on comparing Evernote to OneNote, the five key differences. There's about 166 comments already on this video. Now, you folks have watched the video. You're very passionate about both Evernote and OneNote. You've pointed out lots of different things that I might have missed and different ways of looking at the comparison between OneNote and Evernote. So today, I thought we would visit your comments of OneNote versus Evernote on Ask Dotto Tech. Ask Dotto Tech is the show where you ask questions and I answer them. And my goodness, you have asked a lot of questions and actually made a lot of great points about the comparison that I created between Evernote and OneNote, which we posted just a little bit over a day ago. Now, in this video, if you don't have time to watch it, it's about 30 minutes long, so it's a little long for the Dotto Tech channel. But we looked at five key areas or five key differences between OneNote and Evernote: research and retention, composition and editing, mobility, organization, and recall. And I basically rated the applications and talked about the strengths of the applications and how they worked in each of these areas. For example, in research and retention, Evernote came out ahead because the Evernote web clipper is far more sophisticated than the OneNote web clipper. In composition and editing, on the other hand, OneNote came out ahead because it's a joy to use as a notebook. You have far more flexibility as far as formatting, laying out your page, etc. in OneNote than you do in Evernote. In mobility, the Evernote mobility app is more robust, but it's really nice taking notes, especially on tablets and stuff, in OneNote. Organization, there's a philosophical difference between the two. Evernote is completely based on search, whereas OneNote is much more of a notebook metaphor with visual and hierarchical cues being far more important. And then as far as recall, hands down, that's where Evernote is the strongest because Evernote search just rocks. Now, I pointed out all of these different aspects in the video, and then you've come back and you've pointed out places that that I made some mistakes, but also different ways of looking at the apps and suggestions of things that different ways that the apps work. So I want to share some of those comments with you today on Ask Dotto Tech. And let's get started right here with a comment from Don White, who says, "As many of you pointed out, great video, thanks. By the way, OneNote does an awesome job at OCR for handwritten notes and graphics, making them searchable. Your video seems to imply otherwise." Again, though, thanks for great information. Don is right. Many of you pointed out that when I was talking about one of the strengths of Evernote, one of the things that I appreciate in Evernote is the fact that anytime I take a picture of anything, it looks through that picture to try and find text that it can convert into searchable text. OneNote does the same thing. So if you take a picture of a handwritten note, if you take a picture of a whiteboard, if you take a picture of a magazine or a newspaper article, it's going to convert that into searchable text so that you can later on search on it as you're going through your search. It doesn't change the fact that Evernote is still a stronger search tool because of the way tagging works for context-related search in Evernote, but it is an error that I made and makes OneNote that much more appealing because it does go through all of your images and make the any text within those images searchable. So thanks to Don and many of the rest of you who pointed out that error or that omission where I did not mention that OneNote also has that feature. In a related area, both Etu and Leonardo and many others of you pointed out that I missed talking about an application called Office Lens, which allows you to take pictures to use the OneNote camera far more effectively. Now, one of the things that I pointed out is the Evernote camera is more robust in the mobile app than is the OneNote camera. And so you all pointed out that you don't use the OneNote camera when you're taking images, but you use an application from Microsoft called Office Lens that works as a nice scanner app on your phone, allowing you to scan in documents, whiteboards, etc. And it syncs and links seamlessly with OneNote. That was, again, an omission on my part, but I did not talk about add-on apps. I will give myself kind of a little bit of a pass there because, for example, in the Evernote world, I use Scannable even more than I use the Evernote camera itself. So there are add-on cameras or add-on camera apps, imaging apps, for both of the environments. Office Lens in the Microsoft environment and Scannable in the Evernote environment, and they both make the application that much more robust as far as capturing images and then using those images, of course, as we were talking about, that can be then converted into searchable content. So thank you, Leonardo. Thank you, A2. I appreciate you guys and many others pointing out that Office Lens is an option within the Evernote, or excuse me, within the OneNote world. Now, let's move on to this one here, which is from, I love this, Ken Dog McAwesome. What a fantastic moniker. Well, Ken Dog points out that he spends a fair bit of time talking about how he uses OneNote, but he says at the end, "I was disappointed you didn't mention OneNote's ability to parse audio and video with speech to text and make the text searchable." And I went, holy cow, that is awesome. How did I miss that? Well, how I missed that, it turns out, and it is an awesome feature, how I missed that is it's not a universal feature that's built into OneNote. It is a Windows-only feature that you get in Windows 8 or Windows 10 where you have to integrate it with the Windows operating system and its own text-to-speech converter. And here I find a little document here, which we will include in the notes beneath here, where if you are in the Windows environment, how you can incorporate the ability to record something in OneNote and have that recording then converted into a text document. And there's a little process that you have to go through. It does indeed seem awesome, but it is a Windows-only feature, not available cross-platform, certainly not available in the mobility space or in the iOS or Mac space at this point. So thank you very much for that, Kendall McAwesome. It is, and you are, I did miss it, but it's not quite as disappointing when you realize that it is not for the entire world. The next comment that we have is from Scott Rickson, who says, "Unless I'm missing something, sharing is not the same, because I basically said sharing is pretty much equal between the two applications." Says Scott, "You can only share OneNote at the notebook level. Evernote is great at sharing at just a single note level." I'm using both apps for different things. But at any rate, Scott points out that OneNote's sharing is only at the notebook level and not at the more granular section nor note, individual note level. Whereas in Evernote, we can take any individual note and we can share it, which is the way that I use it to deliver my courses, for example. A little bit of research, and Scott is 100% correct. The OneNote community has been asking Microsoft for a long time to rectify the situation where you can only share notes in OneNote at the notebook level. You have to share an entire notebook. So if you want to share a single page note, you have to make that a notebook of its own in the OneNote world. So not quite as flexible as far as sharing, not quite as full featured as far as sharing as Evernote. And thank you to Scott for pointing that out. Now, Yurislav says that "I definitely missed a handwriting feature implemented in Evernote. Evernote implemented the penultimate on the whole, which is an app that they've had. You just tap on the new text note button, and then down between the gallery and voice memos, you find hand notes. Go ahead and do it." And let's do it. Okay, Yurislav, I'm going to do it right now. So let's go into Evernote on my iOS device, create a new text note, and looky, right there is the pen tool, whereas if I tap on it, I do have the ability, as he says, to be able to mark up and to be able to draw and to be able to work with my finger with a pen, which is actually pretty darn slick. I'm still not going to give Evernote the edge over OneNote in this area because this graphic that I created is in line. I can't position it anywhere on the page as I can in OneNote, but still, I do have the ability to either use my finger or a stylus at this point and be able to take notes and be able to jot down notes in a very similar way to the way that we do it within OneNote. So thank you for pointing that out. I was not aware of that feature. I've never used it before, and I'm glad that you shared it with me. And finally, from Dale Holden, we have a wonderful note that he is a heavy-duty user of OneNote, and he points out that there are some great add-ons that I did not talk about. And he said there's a site called OneTastic that has macros, and this got me a little bit intrigued. Now, because OneNote is part of the Microsoft ecosystem, a lot of the Office-related tools are going to be able to be applied within OneNote. And it's got very nice. I mean, we never did talk about the integration it has with Office 365 and the strength of that integration. That's balanced out by the kind of universal acceptance that Evernote has within the productivity community of hooks into Evernote from other applications. But if you do live in Microsoft ecosystem, OneNote's a joy because of how it integrates with the rest of the Office ecosystem. And part of that is these different macros and these different capabilities that we find at OneTastic that allow you to add all sorts of calendar links and other sorts of additional functionality where they've pre-written all of these macros that you can apply within OneNote. So if you become a OneNote power user, gaining access to these macros can really give you some nice additional workflow and features that we haven't even really touched on as we reviewed the different applications. So there's a quick kind of overview of the response that you've been giving us as far as OneNote versus Evernote. I encourage you to keep on commenting, keep letting us know exactly how you use it. There's lots, if you have time, read through the comments in YouTube, because there are lots of great narratives that people have shared of different ways that they approach different challenges using the two applications. Everybody from authors to teachers, they all talk about how they use the different tools and how they work for them. It's turned into an eye-opening experience. Now, there are three ways for you to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. The first is please subscribe to this channel. The second is subscribe to our newsletter. That way you hear about any upcoming tutorials or courses that we offer here at Dotto Tech. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community-funded resource supported through the generosity of you folks at the crowdfunding site Patreon. If you drop by our Patreon page, you'll discover the perks that are included in supporting Dotto Tech. One of those perks being our Evernote Made Easy course. Till next time, I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.